Good afternoon.
Let us start the lecture after the mid-semester examinations, MSc. This is Embedded System DET 3102. Course outcomes: students will be able to select the relevant microcontrollers for various industrial applications. Students will be able to use embedded C programming language to maintain the embedded system. Students will be able to interpret the communication standards of the embedded system. Students will be able to develop the basic applications of the embedded system. Students will be able to interpret the features of a real-time operating system. So this is the 8051 microcontroller. This is just the revision, brush up of whatever you have learned in the previous semester, micro applications, MAA. So as we know, 8051 is the microcontroller. There are microprocessors, there are microcontrollers. As you know, microprocessors are having a generic architecture. Microcontroller is having embedded type of the architecture, in which it is inbuilt, embedded, the processors, memory, timers, etc. on same chip. Okay. So especially 8051 microcontroller, if you consider its architecture, if you check, it is having some salient features, like it is 8-bit CPU. 8051 is 8-bit CPU. What do you mean by 8-bit CPU? 8-bit CPU means it processes 8-bit data. 8-bit CPU means it can process 8-bit data. What do you mean by processing 8-bit data? Means it can read 8-bit data, it can save 8-bit data, it can retrieve 8-bit data, it can add, subtract, multiply 8-bit data, it can store it into memory 8-bit data. Okay. So if it is handling 8-bit data, then how much register length should be? It should be 8-bit. So microcontroller 8051 is 8-bit CPU. Its CPU is able to handle 8-bit data. Its registers are able to handle or store, transfer 8-bit data. That's why its data bus is all of 8-bit. Its ports also will be 8-bit. Okay. Port 0, it is 8-bit. There are 4 ports. Port 1, it is 8-bit. Port 2, it is 8-bit. Port 3, it is 8-bit. So 8051 microcontroller is 8-bit CPU. Why it is 8-bit CPU? Because it handles 8-bit data. It is having 8-bit register. It is having 8-bit ALU. It is having 8-bit wide data bus. It is 8-bit CPU. It is having on-chip clock oscillator. It is having the clock oscillator which is on the same IC, on-chip clock oscillator. This is one of the salient feature. Then it requires a memory for the program storage or data storage, variable storage, isn't it? And this is having a 4 kilobyte of internal program memory. 8051 architecture, if you look at its features we are discussing. So this 8051 is having 4 kilobyte of internal program memory. Okay, 4 kilobyte of internal program memory. It is, we are calling it as a code memory. Okay, we also call it as a ROM, read only memory, code memory or read only memory. Read only memory means in that memory if you write something and if you power off, turn off the power supply of the IC, and next day if you again power on the IC, that whatever written on that ROM you will get again back, it will be saved as it is. So it is called read only memory. Okay, you must be knowing read only memory, read random access memory, RAM is there, ROM is there. RAM is random access memory, is the memory. In that memory, whenever there is a power supply connected to IC, IC is active. In that case, whatever the data sent into the RAM or is available into the RAM, which can be there available till the power supply is connected. Whenever the power supply is connected to IC, whatever the data present into the RAM, random access memory, will remain there till the power supply is connected. And as soon as we disconnect the power supply, the RAM data will vanish, will disappear. And next time after stopping the power supply, switching off the power supply, again after 1 minute immediately, if you again connect the power supply, the RAM data content will be lost, will be vanished, will not get back. Okay, so this is the RAM. And what about the ROM? In case of ROM, read only memory, you can write the data, save the data into RAM if it is electrically erasable, readable RAM, electrically erasable writable RAM, then you, or flash RAM nowadays, then we can flash ROM. We can write the data into the ROM, and if you switch off power supply of the IC, then also that ROM stores the data and keeps it intact. And when we again connect the power supply next time, after 1 day, 2 day, whatever time, again it can be available into the same location as same data. So this is the difference. ROM will store the data even the power supply goes off, and RAM will store the data and power supply goes off, it will be disappearing, it will be vanished. So this is the difference between RAM and ROM. Please remember, okay, ROM will store data for long time, and RAM will store data only when power supply is available. So in 8051 IC, 8051 chip, the ROM is there of 4 kilobyte, 4 KB of internal program memory is there, code memory, and it is a ROM, read only memory. So 4 kilobyte data, if you saved and if you turn off the kit or IC power supply, then also it will hold that data for next time whenever you start the program. And there is also 128 byte of internal data memory, 128 byte of internal data memory, that is RAM. इंटरनल प्रोग्राम मेमोरी इट इज रॉम, इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी इट इज रैम. सो इट इज 128 बाइट. 4 किलोबाइट इज 4000 बाइट, अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 4000, एंड 128 बाइट इज 128 बाइट. वन बाइट कंटेन्स 8 बिट्स. सो दीज डिटेल्स यू आर नोइंग ऑलरेडी. सो दिस 8051 इज 8 बिट सीपीयू. इट इज हैविंग द ऑन चिप क्लॉक ऑसिलेटर. इट इज हैविंग द रॉम ऑफ 4 किलोबाइट्स इंटरनल प्रोग्राम मेमोरी. 4 किलोबाइट्स ऑफ इंटरनल प्रोग्राम मेमोरी, और इट इज कॉल्ड कोड मेमोरी रॉम. एंड 128 बाइट ऑफ इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी, दैट इज द रैम. ओके, 4 किलोबाइट्स ऑफ इंटरनल प्रोग्राम मेमोरी, दैट इज अ कोड मेमोरी रॉम. एंड 128 बाइट्स ऑफ इंटरनल डेटा मेमोरी, दैट इज द रैम. ठीक है ना, दीज आर द फीचर्स. रिमेंबर दिस, एंड दिस यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन टू MEE. Then there are 64 kilobytes of memory you can connect externally. So 4 kilobyte internal program memory, 128 byte internal data memory, these are on the 8051 IC itself. It is within the IC. Whenever you are having the IC 8051, on the same IC you get 4 kilobyte of internal program memory, 128 byte of internal data memory. Okay, and you are having 64 kilobyte of external program memory address space. Okay, 64 kilobyte of external program memory address space. Address space is provided. The facility of addressing is available. So you can use the 8051 to access the 64 kilobyte of external memory. So you can provide the address to each and every memory location. Total is 64 kilobyte memory locations are there. For 64 kilobyte memory location, to access these memory location, it is needed that total 16 address lines must be there, must be provided, must be available. Okay, for 64 kilobyte of memory, to access that address space, what is required is 16 bit address lines are required. 16 bit address. What is the data bits? How many data bits are there? It is 8 bit CPU. It is 8 bit CPU. Okay. So data lines will be 8 lines. Address lines, how many required? 16. 8 lines data line and address lines 16 are required. So 16 address line can address external program memory. External जर असेल program memory external, तर त्याला address bit lines ची आवश्यकता असते. Internal असेल तर external address line ची आवश्यकता नसते. Internal असेल तर internal command नीच आपल्याला access करता येतो. एक्सटर्नल जर असेल मेमरी, बाहेर दुसरी आय सी मेमरी जी आपण बाहेर कनेक्ट केली पी सी बी वर, आणि जर त्या दुसऱ्या एक्सटर्नल आय सी मधल्या डेटाला आपण तिथं डेटा स्टोअर केला असेल किंवा तिथून रिट्राईव केला असेल, रीड केला असेल, राईट केला असेल, तर आपण त्याला मॅक्झिमम किती करू शकतो 8051 64 किलोबाइट. आणि मग ते करायचं असेल तर ॲड्रेस लागतात, ॲड्रेस लाईन्स लागतात 16. ओके, सो 64 किलोबाइट एक्सटर्नल प्रोग्राम मेमरी ॲड्रेस स्पेस इज प्रोव्हाइडेड, अँड 64 किलोबाइट ऑफ एक्सटर्नल डेटा मेमरी ॲड्रेस, रिपीट झालं आहे, ॲड्रेस स्पेस इज देअर. अँड 32 बाय डायरेक्शनल आयओ लाईन्स आर देअर. 32 bidirectional IO lines are there. IO lines means input output lines. Okay. त्याला आपण काय म्हणतो 8051 मध्ये पोर्ट म्हणतो. पोर्ट किती पोर्ट आहेत, हाउ मेनी पोर्ट्स आर देयर, 4 पोर्ट्स आर देयर, पोर्ट 0, पोर्ट 1, पोर्ट 2, पोर्ट 3, 4 पोर्ट्स आर देयर. ईच पोर्ट इज हैविंग हाउ मेनी लाइन्स, 8 लाइन्स. एवरी पोर्ट इज हैविंग 8 लाइन्स. ओके, सो टोटल पोर्ट्स आर हाउ मेनी, 4 ports. Each port is having how many bits? 8 bits. So 4 port into 8 bits. How many pins are there? Or how many lines are there? 8 bit into 4 port. 8 into 4, 32. So 32 bidirectional IO lines are there. 32 lines are there. They are clubbed into 8 each. 8 lines, port 0. Light gali. So let us start. Light mode disturbance zala. So 64 kilobyte external memory access karu shakte. 32 bit si bidirectional IO lines ahet. Ani tyache 4 port ahet. 4 ports are there. Each port is having 8 bits. 4 8-bit ports are there, 4 8-bit ports or 32-bit individually addressable IO lines. So individually each line can be addressed or in group of 8 also can be addressed. So port 1 complete 8 lines can be addressed at the same time or individual line can be addressed. So these facilities are there. Total 32 bidirectional IO lines. What do you mean by bidirectional? Bidirectional means both the direction, input and output. So if the lines are input lines, then the data flows from external circuit into the 8051. And if the line is output line, the data flows from 8051 to the external circuit. So it is IO line, input output line. So it should be bidirectional. So 32 bit bidirectional lines are there. Then 2 16 bit timer counters are there, T0, T1. 2 16 bit timer counters are there. Timer or counter, as we know, we can use it as a timer, as a counter. So we can have the external sensor circuitry and it senses one object is passed, second is passed, third is passed, fourth is passed. It counts the objects, it counts the persons, it counts the events. One pulse, second pulse, third pulse, fourth pulse. And accordingly, it is counted into the 8051 microcontroller. So it is acting as a counter to measure how many events are occurring, to measure how many objects are passing through. It is counter. What about timer? Suppose we want to have certain time duration measurement or certain time duration application, we can provide say few milliseconds, few microseconds time duration, and for that we can apply the timer facility. Just like our alarm in the clock is there. So suppose at 10 o'clock we set a timer alarm for early morning, say 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Then total 8 hours timer will be there, isn't it? From 10 night to 6 morning. At 6 morning, it will give the alarm. So similarly, the timer is there. For particular time duration, you can set the timer. And once you start the timer, it will start counting it, and after that time duration it will give some indication, it will generate some signal. So two 16-bit timer as well as counter, internal timer or counter facility are available. So there are resistors. In that register you can get either the counted number, or in that register you can submit the timer number accordingly, the time clock of the microcontroller, the that number will go on reducing one by one, and it will generate the timer pulse. It will generate the, raise the timer pulse. So two 16-bit timer counter T0 T1 are there, and it is having a full duplex serial data receiver transmitter facility. So there are simplex and duplex types of the communications. Duplex means both the way communications are there. So there are full duplex serial data receiver transmitter connectors are there, facility is there. On one pin there will be you can use that pin for transmitter, and other is used, can be used as receiver. So for transmission and reception with full duplex, that means simultaneously, full duplex means simultaneously it can be transmitting and at the same time it can be receiving, full duplex. Half duplex means the, it can transmit as well as receive, but one at a time. Whenever it is transmitting, reception is stopped. Whenever it is receiving, transmission is stopped. And simplex means only one, either transmission or reception. Simplex. Duplex means both transmitter as well as reception. Reception. And in case of transmission and reception, both it may be duplex full or duplex half. That means simultaneously transmission reception is available, or one at a time. Okay, so full duplex serial data receiver and transmitter. Okay, 8051 architecture. 8051 architecture is also having some salient features, like four register banks are there. Okay, in total memory of 4K, four register banks are there with 8 register in each bank. Four different bank of the registers are there. One register will have 8-bit data. One register will have 8-bit data. The bunch of 8 such register are there. Bunch of 8 register. 8 register will make a 1 register bank. So 1 register bank contains 8 registers. 1 register contains 8 bits. So 8 bit for 1 register. One more 8 register for second register. One more 8 register for third register. Again 8 bits for 4. 8 bits for 5th, 8 bits for 6th, 8 bits for 7th, and 8 bits for 8 registers. So such 8 registers, each is having 8 bits, 8 registers will make 1 register bank. Okay. So 1 register bank contains 8 registers. Such 4 register banks are there, 4 register banks of 8 registers are there. Then 16-bit program counter is there, PC. Program counter, which is holding the current address of the memory, where the currently code is getting executed. So 16-bit program counter is there, PC, and data pointer is also there, DPTR, data pointer. Okay, data pointer is also there, DPTR, data pointer, DPTR. 16-bit program counter and data pointers are there. Similarly, 8-bit program status word is there, PSW. Similar to 8051 microprocessor, here in 8051 architecture, right? The 8051 microcontroller, 8-bit program status word is there, PSW. What it does, what is its role, PSW, program status word? It holds the status of various actions and various results. It holds the status of various results. So suppose what is the output is there after processing, if that output is even parity, odd parity, whether it is over carry, where it is nibble over carry or byte over carry, whether it is negative or positive, okay, it is parity is even or odd, okay, and zero. So this type of the, if any interrupt is there, this status it shows. So 8-bit program status word is there. Then 8-bit stack pointer is also there. 8-bit stack pointer is also there. Okay. 8-bit stack pointer is also there. What is stack pointer? So there is the memory which can be used for storing whatever the data you want to store, okay, that can be called as a stack of data. So once the stack pointer is initialized at that address, the data will be stored and automatically stack pointer will increase, okay, just go on stacking one above other. And whenever we are popping this, that is, again, if you are taking from the stack, it will go on other way, reducing. And the next one by one stack will be read. So this is the stack pointer, 8-bit stack pointer, which is pointing to the stack. So on that stack you can push the register data, or you can push any other data if you want, address or PSW or register, any data you can push or you can store, and you can retrieve. In some application, in some cases, in some situations, suppose you want to, the 8051 want to relinquish the control over the program counter, so it can push that program counter on the stack, and you can, it can relinquish the control of the bus. And suppose any other processing is requiring that that process, suppose interrupt or like that, it can use that program counter, it can execute the interrupt routine, and again whatever stored on the stack can be taken back into the PC after completing that, and again the original program will start from that particular location. For that, these purposes stack is used. So for indicating that, pointer is there, that is called stack pointer. 8-bit stack pointer is there. Program counter is regular program counter, and stack pointer is indicating the stack memory for storing. Then 5 vector interrupts are there, actually 6 are there, 5 vector interrupts are there, and reset is not considered as the interrupt, reset is also there. 6 interrupts are there, interrupt structure, 5 vector interrupt structures is there. What do you mean by interrupt? Just we have seen, whenever there is external pulse generated as an interrupt, that pulse will halt the current execution, okay, external interrupt will halt the current execution, and it will turn to the interrupt serving routine, and it will ask the processor to execute its routine. And according to the priority, either it is to be executed or not, it will be depending on according to the priority, either it will execute or it will keep it into the queue. So So this is called interrupt. You must have studied this. So 5 vector interrupts are there. So 8051 CPU consists of 8-bit ALU, okay, and with associated registers. There are different registers are there, like accumulator, A register, B register, then PSW register is there, okay. So status word, isn't it? PSW, program status word register. Then SP is there, stack pointer. Then PC is there, 16-bit program counter is there. Then stack pointer is there. And data pointer is DPTR, is 16-bit data DPTR is there. So ALU is there. It can perform arithmetic and logic function on 8-bit variable. ALU perform arithmetic and logic function on 8-bit variables. ALU can perform arithmetic and logic functions on 8-bit variables. 8051 has 128 bytes of internal RAM, which is divided into working registers, 00 to 1F, bit addressable memory area, 20 to 2F, general purpose memory area, scratchpad memory, 30 to 7F. Okay, so working registers are there, 00 to 1F. Okay. These working registers, R0 to R7, are there. And then there is a bit addressable area is also there. Okay. So in that bit addressable area, individual bit can be addressed. Individual bit can be either set or reset. Individual bit can be read or written. Okay. Individual bit can be modified. Individual bit can be processed. That means individual bit can be addressed for reading or writing. So individual bit addressable memory is also there. Area is also there. That is from address 20 to 2F. Working registers are having address 00 to 1F. And other remaining is general purpose memory area is there, which is called scratchpad memory. It is from 30 to 7F. 128 byte memory is there. Okay. So these are some features. A graphical presentation of this memory we can check now with this. So this is the architecture. Yeah. After architecture we'll check the memory details also, graphical representation, whatever. So as we see in this architecture, there is internal bus, there is a CPU. These are the internal buses. This is the internal this is the CPU. There is oscillator circuit internal. Externally, we have to connect the crystal. Internal oscillator is there, internal CPU is there. Then there is an on-chip ROM is there for program code. It is called program memory. ROM memory is program memory. Similarly, on-chip RAM is there. On-chip means on the same IC. RAM is also there, isn't it? ROM is there, 4K ROM, 128K byte RAM is there. There are timers, timer 0, timer 1, T0, T1. And for that, whatever the inputs are there, counter inputs are there. So timer or counter. There are serial port is there, transmitter receiver serially, duplex, full duplex type serial port is there. Isn't it? We have seen it. Full duplex. That means whenever a receiver is sending external circuit is sending the data and it is being received by the circuit. The circuit, this IC, microcontroller. The microcontroller also send the data to the as a transmitter to the external circuit. From external circuit, whenever the microcontroller is receiving the data on the received pin, at the same time, microcontroller can send the data over the transmitter pin to the external circuit. So simultaneously reception and transmission goes on. It is called full duplex serial port. Then there are four IO ports. Four ports are there. IO ports, input output port, 32-bit bidirectional pins are there. 32-bit bidirectional pins, just we have seen. So each port, four ports are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each port is having 8-bit. This is having 8-bit. This is having 8-bit. This is also having 8-bit. This is also having 8-bit. P0, P1, P2, P3, all are 8 bits. And all are group wise, that is port wise can be addressed. And all the lines are line wise, individually can be addressed. Only single port line also can be addressed for outputting or inputting. Okay. Then there is a bus control for bus operation, and there is interrupt controller for interrupt operation. So interrupt controller controls the external interrupt. There are external interrupts are there, NT0 to NT1 and so on. External interrupts are there. So we have seen 5-6 interrupts are there. So these interrupts can be controlled by interrupt controller. So CPU is there, oscillator is there, on chip ROM is there, on chip RAM is there, timers are there, serial port is there, IO ports are there, 32-bit bidirectional IO ports, bus control is there, and interrupt controller is there. So this is about the architecture, internal block diagram of the 8051. This we have already seen, you have already studied into previous semester 4 MAA subject. So if you compare this architecture with some other microcontrollers, 8051 architecture is shown in first column, 8051. Okay, so this is 8051, first column. So other microcontrollers are there, 8052, 8051, 8751. So 8031 is the previous microcontroller than 8051, and 8052 is more inclusive, advanced microcontroller, and 8751 is also further advanced, different. So 8051 is a subset of 8052. Okay. So if you consider one by one features, ROM, 8051 is 4K, 8052 is having 8K, and 8751 is having 4K UEEPROM. It is UEEPROM, but 8031 is having no ROM memory. Program memory is not there in the 8031. Then RAM is there, 128 byte for 8051 and 8031 and 8751. All three is having 128 byte, whereas 8052 it is having 256 byte RAM. Then there are timers. Timers are also same condition. 8051 two timers are there. 8031 two timers are there. 8751 two timers are there, and 8052 three timers are there. 8052 three timers. 8051, 8031, 8751 all are having two timers, and 8052 three timers. So these are the timers. Then similarly, IO pins, all four are having 32-bit IO pins. All four are having four ports. Each port is having 8 bits. IO pins are 32-bit IO pins. All four are having one serial port. That means one transmitter pin, one receiver pin, one serial port. Okay. All are having 32-bit IO pins. All are having one serial port. All are having interrupts. Now interrupt will vary. 8051 is having 6 interrupts, 8031 6 interrupts, 8751 6 interrupts, but 8052 8 interrupts are there. Watchdog timers, no is there in each microcontroller except 8031. Okay. So this is the comparison. Basically we are interested in 8051. Okay. So in case of 8051, we have seen data memory structure of 8051 controller. If you consider, internal data memory of 8051 is divided into two groups. Internal data memory is there 256, isn't it? RAM, internal data memory, ROM is there, that is the program memory, code memory, and 128 byte is internal data memory. 128 byte internal data memory. So this 128 byte is divided into two groups. Okay, so internal data memory 128 byte RAM is divided into two groups. One is a set of 8 registers and remaining is a scratch pad memory. Out of 128, 8 register set is there and remaining 120 registers are there. थोड़ा वेळ 10-20 मिनिट लेक्चर चालू संपत आले म्हणून सेट ऑफ 8 रजिस्टर्स आर देयर 8 रजिस्टर्स अँड स्क्रॅच पॅड मेमरी रिमेनिंग इज देअर दीज 8 रजिस्टर्स आर R0 to R7 8 रजिस्टर्स आर देअर These 8 registers are having addresses, and this address range is how much? Is 00 to 07. Okay, address range is 00 to 07. It is used to access the registers R0 to R7. There are registers R0 to R7, isn't it? And it can be accessed. R0 can be accessed with 00, R1 can be accessed with 01, R2 can be accessed with 02, R3 can be accessed with 03, R4 can be accessed with 04, R5 can be accessed with 05, R6 can be accessed with 06, R7 can be accessed with 07H. These are the hex numbers 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07H, 00H, 07H, isn't it? These are the hex numbers. So address range is 00 to 07 registers. Okay. Other than these registers R0 to R7, the rest are scratch pad memory. So first 8 registers are R0 to R7. Other than these registers, remaining all is called scratch pad memory. Scratch pad memory. Okay. So this total data, internal data memory is 128 byte internal data memory is divided into two groups. One is set of 8 register and other is scratch pad memory. So 8 register R0 to R7 has a address range 00H to 07H. So which is shown here. Okay. Data memory structure is shown here for 80 microcontroller. Internal data memory is there. And this is, these are the registers 00 to 7. Sorry, the internal data memory is there, that is 00 to 7F. Out of this internal data memory, first 8 registers are there, that those are the R0 to R7 and remaining will be other registers, general purpose registers. And there are some special function registers are there, SFR. These special function registers are ranging from having the address from 80 to FF, isn't it? So if you remember, so this is 128 RAM, okay, program memory, but this is having some SFR also, special function space, SFR space, special function register space, that is 80 to FF. So FF means it has now become 256 total. 128 is there for internal data memory, that is program memory, data memory, internal data memory, only 128. But total is, along with SFR, it becomes double, that is 256. This is 8051 architecture. Then data memory structure of 8051, it is having 8051 provides four register banks, as we know, R0, R1, R2, R3. Four register banks, only one register bank can be used at a time. Out of these, only one can be accessed, used at a time. Then register bank selection is with two bits in PSW. PSW means what? PSW is program status word. As we know, there is one 8-bit PSW register is also there in the 8051 microcontroller. So this 8051 microcontroller PSW is there, that is having 8 bits. Out of these, 2 bits are the status bits which can be used for setting which register bank is to be used. Which register bank can be selected? The register bank selection is with 2 bits of PSW. So PSW 2 bits can be used for selecting which register bank is to be used. Only one register bank can be used at a time in the program. One register bank contains 8 registers. And what are the address range? Register bank 0, register bank 1, addressing used to select the register banks. That is register bank 2, register bank 3, register banks are there. And address range for register bank 0, 00H to 07H. Register bank 1, 08H to 0FH. Register bank 2, 10H to 17H. And register bank 3, 180H to 1FH. Okay. So, these are the addresses. Register banks are there, 0 to 3. 4 register banks are there. Register bank 0, 00H to 07H. H means hex. These are the address range, 00 to 07. Register bank contains 8 registers. Register bank 0 contains 8 registers. Register bank 1 contains 8 registers. Register bank 2 contains 8 registers. Register bank 3 contains 8 registers. Isn't it? Each bank contains 8 registers. If it contains 8 registers, there must be 8 different addresses. And if you check, there are 8 different addresses available. Suppose register bank 0, what are the 8 different addresses? 00, 01, 02, 03, all are hex. 00H, 01H, 02H, 03H, 04H, 05H, 06H, 07H. Total 8 registers are there in the register bank 0. Similarly, register bank 1. Register bank 1 contains again 8 registers. 08H, 09H, 0AH, 0BH, 0CH, 0DH, 0EH, 0FH. Total 8 combinations, 8 addresses for register bank 1. And register bank 2, after 0F, what is the next address? 10. 10H, 11H, 12H, 13H, 14H, 15H, 16H, 17H. Register bank 2. After 17, there will be 18 for register bank 3. 18H, 19H, 1AH, 1BH, 1CH, 1DH, 1EH, 1FH. This is for register bank 3. Okay. In this way, register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, register bank 3. These 4 banks are having, each bank having 8 registers. So, 4 banks are having 32 registers. So, these register will have 32 different addresses from 00 to 1F. This makes 32 different addresses. Isn't it? It's simple. It is having 32 different addresses. Okay. So, 8051 memory structure is having 4 register banks, register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, register bank 3. Each register bank is having its address range. 8 registers will have 8 combination of the address, 8 addresses. So it is having address range 00 to 07H, 08H to 0FH, 10H to 17H, and 18H to 1FH. So this is about the these register banks 0, 1, 2, 3. Then if you consider again the data memory structure of 8051 microcontroller, the concept of these four register banks is very useful. There are four different register banks are there. It is useful. This feature is good in using for serving the interrupts. So whenever you are interrupts routines are written or interrupts are being served, this feature is very good in case of this interrupt servicing. So whenever there is interrupt, there it has to serve the interrupt routine, isn't it? Microcontroller or any microprocessor has to go to the interrupt routine and serve that interrupt routine and come back to the original program and again run the original program, execute the original program. So this is the functioning of the interrupts, provided the interrupt will have that much priority. So it is useful in the register banks are very useful in the concept of the interrupts. So this feature is good using servicing the interrupts. The interrupt program use one bank. The interrupt program uses one bank. The interrupt service routine ISS access another bank. So there will be separation between the two different register banks. So they will not mingle with each other. They will not mix with each other. So it is in this way it becomes very helpful in case of the interrupts. Using a separate register banks gives better performance. Okay. Using separate register banks, it gives the better performance. No mixing of the two different data sets are there. So one is for interrupt program is used, other is for interrupt service routine, ISS is used. The four bank helps the functioning in of nested interrupts. So there are also nested interrupts are there. One interrupt controller is used. One set of interrupts, suppose there are 6 interrupts are there. You can next again more each interrupt with one more set of interrupts. So out of 6, first interrupt is used with more set of interrupts. Second interrupt is used with more set of interrupts. Third is also used with more set of. Suppose first is used is again with 6 or 8. Second is used with 6, third is, so 6 into 6, 36 interrupt it can serve. So it is called nested interrupts, nested interrupt. So in this way it can be useful into nested interrupt. Okay. So on this again memory structure feature, the four register banks are there. Other than the register bank area, it is a scratch pad area. Scratch pad area will be 20H to 7FH. Just like the register bank addresses, scratch pad area also will have address as 20H to 7FH. Scratch pad area address is 20H to 7FH. Again, from 20H to 7FH, 16 bytes or 128 bits are used. 16 byte. Each byte will have 8 bits. How many bits will become? 16 into 8, it is 128 bits, isn't it? 16 byte or 128 bit. There are 16 bytes. 16 registers are there. These are used as bit addressable RAM. For addressing bit wise, there are total 16 registers used. 16 bytes are there, isn't it? 16 byte of registers are bit addressable. So each byte is having 8 bits, so 16 into 8, 128 bits will be there. So it, all these bits are bit addressable. What do you mean by bit addressable? Bit addressable means that individual bit out of the total 8 bit, only one bit can be written or read. That is called bit addressable. Okay, only single bit can be written or read. It is called bit addressable. Okay, single bit can be addressed. It is called bit addressable. So, four register banks are there. Other than the register bank area in the scratch pad area will be 20H to 7FH. Again, from 20H to 2H. 2FH is 16 by 128 bits, which are used for bit addressable RAM. Okay, these are used for bit addressable RAM. So individual bit by bit addressing can be done. The same is shown here in this pictorial representation. Internal data memory organization is there. Internal data memory organization in that 00H it starts. Register bank is there. This is register bank area. 00H to 1FH. 7, 8 registers are there, isn't it? R0 to R7 register bank area. 00 to 1F. Okay. 16 bank registers are there, 16 registers. Okay. Total 16 bytes are there. Then bit addressable is 20 to 2F. 20 to 2F. Then 30H to 7FH, rest of the RAM is there. 00 to 1F, 4 these are there, 4 banks of the register. Each bank contains 8 registers. Each bank contains 8 registers. This we have seen in the this. 00 to 1F. 00 to 1F. So these are the address for register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, register bank 3. 00 to 1F. Okay. 00 to 1F. These are the register bank area. 4 banks are there. Each bank contains 8 registers. So there are total 32 registers. So 00 to 1F are 32 different addresses. Bit addressable area, 16 registers are there. On this slide we have seen 16 bytes are there. That is 128 bit. So 00 to 2F are 16 combinations. And from after 2F there will be 30H. 2FH then 30H. 30H to 7FH are rest of the RAM area. So, 4 banks, register bank area 00 to 1F, 20H to 2FH, bit addressable area, 16 different registers and rest of the RAM is there. Rest of the area of RAM is there. Okay. Similarly, the register bank area is shown. This register bank area 00 to 1F, these details are shown here. Register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, register bank 3, register bank 0, 00 to 7H as shown here. 00 to 7H. Next is 8 to 0F. So it is next is 8 to 0F. So 00 to 7, 8 to 0F, 10 to 17 and 18 to 1F. These are the different register bank addresses. Register bank addresses. Okay. Now the bit addresses. As we have seen here, total 32 registers are there, and then total 16 bit addressable registers are there, 16. Okay, so register bank is having, each bank is having 8 registers, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, these are the 8 registers. And bit addressable register, this is in one bank, 4 banks are there. What about the bit addressable register? 16 registers are there, 1, 2, up to 16. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 2A, 2B, 2C, 2D, 2E, 2F, 16 are there, isn't it? And each register is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bits. So all the bits can be addressed. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. 0E, 0F, 0E, 0D, 0C, 0B, 0A, 09, 08. Bit addressable. Okay. And similarly this, 7F, 7E, 7D, 7C, 7B, 7A, 79, 78. So all these are the bit addressable areas. Individual bit can be addressed. Addressed means it can be written or read, single bit. Okay. So thank you. Be at home. Be healthy. Be safe. We'll stop here for today's ES lecture, and tomorrow we'll continue OHSS as well as ES lecture. Thank you.